Welcome to the second video in our Get Started video series. Here, we'll explain what mutual funds are and answer the common questions that any first-time mutual fund investor would have. In this video, we explain why you need mutual funds when you can get pretty decent returns on FDs or small savings schemes such as Public Provident Fund, NSC and the like. If you are scratching your head around what mutual funds are, we'd highly recommend you watch the first video in this series and then continue with this one. You can access all these videos and many more relevant things for a new investor from the link of our Get Started webpage in the description box below. But if you're aware of mutual funds and can't convince yourself of their utility beyond the conventional small savings schemes, then watch on. Trust me, this video is going to be an eye-opener. So here we go. Most Indians, including my parents and their parents, and just about everyone I know who's a generation older, have been meticulous savers and avid investors in bank FDs and PPFs. The other day, I was discussing the importance of investing with my father, and he proudly told me that he had inherited the virtue of disciplined investing from my grandfather. So much that he invested his first paycheck into a bank FD. Gradually, this one FD became two, three, and eventually a bunch of them over the years. But then I asked him, why didn't he get rich despite him being such a great saver? Why did he always worry about providing good education to my sister and saving for his retirement, leaving alone other fancy goals? That caught him thinking really hard. The real reason is inflation. The truth is that despite saving so well and earning seemingly good returns on FDs and other small savings schemes, the return was never really good enough to meaningfully beat inflation. It was merely a return illusion. Now let me explain with an example. Do you buy milk at the same rate you used to 10 years back? Absolutely not. A 1-litre packet of Amul milk, which used to cost Rs. 30 in 2010, now tips your pocket with 58 rupees. A rise of more than 90% in 10 years. The same goes for other daily expenses, and the future is certainly not any better. This general increase in prices leading to a fall in the purchasing value of the money is called inflation. If you had 1 lakh rupees in cash in 2001, its worth would not be more than 27,000 rupees in 2021. Over the last two decades, the average inflation has been about 6%, and it has most of the time been similar to the return on FD or even higher. If you also consider taxes on interest earned, your money effectively shrinks instead of growing. Coming back to the conversation with my father, my question about not getting rich changed the course of our discussion. So I asked him to pull out the details of all his investments done to date. I insisted to illustrate him with hard numbers what's been happening all these years. I put all those in the My Investments portfolio tracker at Value Research Online and showed him his inflation-adjusted returns. The results were baffling. Just 1.9% per annum real returns after all the years of postponing wants and saving with discipline. Hardly the stuff that makes anyone rich. He understood the fallacy or the return illusion. FDs provided him guaranteed returns, but they were guaranteed to keep him away from becoming well off. This is the story of millions of Indian middle-class savers. Now let me show you an alternate reality. Instead of FDs, had he put all that money simply in the BSE Sensex Index, which is a basket of 30 stocks all those years, he would have earned 8.8% inflation-adjusted returns per annum. And this is how his wealth would have looked like. Now that looks closer, much closer to being well off, isn't it? Thus, for a smart investor, the purpose should not just be to save and put it in an FD and feel happy about it. Of course, investing is important, but the purpose of investing is to grow your money in real terms. So what's the solution? How can you earn better returns despite inflation? Well, the only solution is to move beyond the comfort of assured returns provided by fixed income investments and embrace equity, that is stocks. Equity is the only asset class that beats inflation hands down over the long term. And mutual funds are the most convenient option for retail investors to invest in equity. So the next time you plan to start a new FD or put some more money in your PPF account, think again. We know you'd have many other questions before making your mind on mutual funds ahead of guaranteed return options like FDs. You've heard stories about how equity destroys wealth just as quickly, isn't it? And what about their costs? Well, worry not. We'll answer all of those in this series. Look out for our other videos where we answer similar questions and many other questions, one at a time. But for now, your most important takeaway from this video is that FDs provide guaranteed returns, but guaranteed low returns, which aren't going to make you rich. Investing in mutual funds in the right way is a much better alternative for wealth creation.